Breakpoint tournament, and now we are in top 32.
Yeah, I'm joined by Schulkinator. My name is Matthias Bayern. And yeah, we are gonna see how top 32 expands.
Yes,
how
it I can read which players got into 32. So on the winner sides, we have True4 and Putzi. Okay. They play now.
Yeah, nothing match. Unexpected, yes. Because True4 is seed number one. He is from Germany,
yeah.
And the third best as a player in Germany.
Yeah. And then also Sintro, yeah. Schocker made it in winner side.
Yeah, Schocker is really surprising, yeah. In winner side.
And Clemens and Puchogi.
He made a huge upset, Schocker.
Yeah, yeah.
He won against Dimitri.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So really. Yes. Really nice win from him.
And then Puchogi also made it
against
you.
Me. Yeah. Yeah.
And
plays against Clemens.
Then Raban versus Tommy, Yeti versus Fies.
Yeah.
Alex versus Veloci, we will see it later.
Yeah, we'll see it later.
And
so
there's Marix.
Vic against Sansi.
Sansi, and the last one in winner side is Luigi player against Kuhlmann. But now we focus on True4 versus.
Yeah, Basel. So we'll probably see the Schulk against Chrome.
Yes.
I am not expecting any weird picks from them.
I wonder if True4 knows that Bazi likes to pick Lylat, but probably he will ban it anyway.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, I know Bazi doesn't like the no platform stages, so he always bans. Did you catch which stage?
Where is it? Ah, go plans. Nice.
Oh, okay. So we are actually going to a no platform stage. Mm-hmm. And yeah, of course, with Schulk, you almost always go for the Speed Monado in the beginning.
Speed Monado art, yeah.
Yeah, it's really good.
Good pressure from True4 in the beginning now.
Yeah, those back airs are so scary.
There is the true
because
combo.
It's even if you parry it, it's hard to respond to a back air. You can't really punish it.
Every time True4 gets grabbed, he goes into shield immediately.
Yeah, so really intelligent use of the shield monado by him. A nice back air again.
And
oh.
The smash should seal it, yes.
Yeah, we see a lot of
such a bad recovery.
A lot of forward air edge guarding.
Yeah.
With
forward air is the best edge guarding tool from Schulk.
Yeah. And it, if he spaces it correct, it even reaches beneath the edge.
Yes.
So
yes.
That's really good.
And when opponents are hanging too long on the ledge, you can just forward air with Smash Monado.
Yeah. Ooh, nice big air.
It seems like Buzz is bringing it a little bit back.
Oh, the triple forward air. And he somehow fell out of the upbeat.
So Pichog is saying everything is best of five in top,
yeah.
32. But it doesn't matter, True4 is still in,
yeah,
the lead.
He's still in the lead.
And he could have maybe done another forward air,
yeah.
Stock before, but
ooh, the up tilt and up B. Up,
yeah.
B out of shield is actually really,
yeah.
Good because
both have good up
it has so much range.
Schulk and Chrome,
I mean,
oh, nice,
nice
take.
Yeah. And yeah, Smash Monado art.
Scary. You see, he's fishing for those forward airs.
Yeah.
There is up tilt.
Up tilt. Up tilt really strong also.
Yeah, it kills it 100% or so with Smash Monado up.
Yeah. Jump Monado up. The spot dodge to get out of the grab.
He's also going for the up B, so quasi.
Yeah. Yeah, those nairs.
True4 is doing really good spacing work with those
really
back
nice,
airs.
Yeah.
You can see when True4 is changing to Smash Monado art, Bazi tries to be very careful.
Yeah, and now we saw it again. The
oh, nice vision.
Nice. We saw it again, the forward air catching it. And
that's,
I think it was forward air, right? The last move from Fulk got the kill.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. You hardly ever see the vision. Really huge for him. Yeah.
Trufer normally almost never goes for the vision, but in this case it was really
against Chrome it's really good. And
because many people, including Trufer and many other Shulk players, are saying that Shulk has the worst counter in the game.
Yeah, or at least one of the worst.
It used to be useful in Smash 4, but now it's...
It doesn't go through shield. So
it doesn't go through shield, it doesn't kill as early as in Smash 4.
Yeah, that's really unfortunate for Shulk.
It was nerfed so badly from Smash 4 to Smash Ultimate.
So Trufer taking the first game. And
now Buzz is going to for the tripod. So.
Yeah.
He got the first parry but didn't recognize that there was a second one needed.
Up B out of shield again.
And again a good start for 2-4.
Yeah, he's in the percent lead and with Buster Monado Art you can rack up so much damage.
He already has 100% almost.
Yeah.
Oh, this
the upfield would have.
Yes, it would have
definitely.
Killed.
But
he tries to go for the counter again, but this time Buzz is
well timed.
Yep.
From Buzzy.
Oh,
this
nice
is the take.
Forward air.
That forward tilt was probably a misinput.
Oh, down air spike. No follow up.
And F tilt almost gets killed.
Yes, so now of course Shulk Trufer now is also in kill percent. Any move could kill now.
He always like the last two times he snapped the ledge, so that's actually something you have to practice with Shulk because it's not that easy.
Yeah. When you get juggled into the air
forward throw.
It's useful to go into shield Monado Art, and when you get thrown off stage it's also good, or at least jump Monado, you can see it here.
Not killing yet. Because it was on the other side of the stage.
Yeah. And there was no rage, so.
Yeah. Now we have to see how he gets the kill with the nice back air.
The crowd is cheering for Buzzy, for the underdog.
Yeah, for the Austrian player, of course. You see almost no knockback with shield Monado.
Oh, and very nice
wait, yeah.
Yes. Buzz is playing really good now, and it's...
Yeah, he is in the lead.
Tries to end him, but... Again. Look at this. It was
0-0
at the
really
beginning
nice,
almost, and now... Now he's... Oh, nice!
That was a sick
combo.
Yeah.
Into down air. But and it doesn't do that much damage. You can see it. It's only 35%.
He knows that... True Four is in kill percentage, but with
not
shield
with
Monado,
no.
Not really. Yeah, he always snaps the ledge.
Nice,
it was a
string
really good read.
Yeah, True Four is trying to bring it back. I think it's his most important goal is now not to die and rack up more damage.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Oh, and they have to
change to the Smash Monado, but now it's looking good for Buzzy.
Yeah, really good. But
nice.
Gonna be the kill.
Yes.
Yeah. Doesn't
that
make it back from
unfortunate
for
position Buzzy because he was very much in the lead.
And now with Buster, he also gets more damage,
gets,
so it's kind of a risk.
30% more damage, but he deals 40% more.
Oh,
so
it's better to go for it.
It used to be a bit better in Smash 4 because you didn't get that much damage in Smash 4. And there is a Smash Monado Art and...
Oh!
And again!
But it's not over, yeah.
Now it's over. And
with the
run-up
switch
into jump Monado Art.
But, I mean, over the most part of the game it was quite even and
Buzzy was in the lead,
so it's gonna be interesting. Maybe it can get to...
He just has to be careful to snap the ledge and don't get caught in the counter, because Shulk's counter isn't as good as, for instance, many other characters like Petra, so at the ledge.
But then also it's really hard to recover as Chrome when you're off stage.
Yeah.
There's not much you can do. Air dodge
And hope you're blessed. Pussy goes again for Yoshi's story, and I think it's a good choice because I don't think it's a good stage for Shulk. I don't like to play on the stage.
Yeah, and also he did really good last game, so...
And I guess Trufa probably banned Lyle because it would be even worse. Shulk.
And probably he also banned
for a lot of reasons.
Battlefield, because Battlefield is also not
I mean, it's similar
good
to
for
this.
Yeah, it's not that good for Shulk also.
And now it looks quite even. Trufa stays in shield art as long as he's in the air. And I think he tried to go for counter again, but now Shulk's counter doesn't come out that fast. So.
Yeah. Jab back air is like the kill confirm combo that you see him trying to go for it a lot, but Trufa never fell for
again,
it. And he takes the stock with
forward air is the best kill move from Shulk. He faked to go into Buster, but then went with a Speed Monado to get more aerial drift.
Forward tilt. Trufa always lives at those high percentages. It's
again, 150 right. And he gets his early kills, the Smash Monado.
So, Fuzzy needs to find a way to kill him. But then again, with Shield Monado, it's so hard to kill Shulk.
Mm-hmm.
And
there it is, forward tilt.
Yeah. Gets the kill again.
Again, early percents, Shulk, Speed Monado out. Now let's see if True 4 can get some Buster damage. But now it's the opposite, and now he switches to shield immediately.
Yeah.
I see it.
So actually, the Buster was in favor of Fuzzy.
Fuzzy, yeah.
And again Buster, but the instant switch to speed.
Yeah. But Buzz is doing this really well. Again, you often see this forward air battles. Both people do the forward air, but Chrome's is a little bit faster, so often he wins.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. But three or four times in a row, but with Shield Monado you don't go anywhere.
And there is
again the early kill with Smash Monado.
Yeah, the Smash Monado was really helping.
As an opponent, you have really to respect the Smash Monado. You can switch within a second or even less into Smash Monado, so you have always to keep it in mind.
Yeah.
And again, Trufa is living up to 150% as usual.
Buster mode.
Now he gets those percentages with Buster.
But there is the back air.
And you can see this match is really has caught the interest of the people because the whole crowd is full.
Of course, Trufa is a huge name and everyone was hyped that he's coming. Players actually voted.
There was a poll between him
and Saif. Also a very good player.
And Trufa won by a far margin. Yeah,
it's so close. And
nice back air. And now he.
Oh, the air dodge. Gets back to the stage.
But it's really bad.
Oh, the forward will be.
That's the game.
Off stage, yeah.
And that's
again
the
Smash Monado.
Most of the kills were with Smash Monado up.
Yeah, but Buzzy was really close a few games. I mean, he
it was
could have
bad.
Taken
was,
one game at least. So next up we have Veloci against
Alex,
Oasis Alex.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be interesting because Alex is playing
Rob. Yeah.
And Veloci, I'm interested in what he will play because he
probably Greninja.
Yeah, on Twitter he stated that he will probably go main Greninja from now on because in the past he played Palu.
Palutena, yeah.
And I don't know. He was not that happy with her, so he switched to Greninja, but still has her as a pocket.
Do you know why he doesn't? He isn't that happy with her because she's still really good, and Nairo won a huge tournament a few weeks
maybe
ago.
Maybe sometimes it's just like you don't feel the character anymore, and you need some other character experiences to appreciate what your character really is, and maybe in the future he will come back to maining Palu again.
Yes, I mean he can still play him. Her.
Yeah.
And maybe he will switch to her when time is right or when he thinks it's needed.
Yeah.
So actually we can take a look at the brackets from Vilugi and from... Vilugi played against Wutanfall and...
Oh yeah, the Captain
Ozolist. Falcon. Yes.
Ozolud. Yeah.
And Alex played against Rick Wando and against Piu, the other Palutena, right?
Okay, yeah. And he, they both won both games, of course.
Of course, because they are now in winner's setting. Yeah.
So, did you actually hear what stage they picked?
Or? No, I'm not even sure. We will see it anyways. And he goes for Palutena now.
Oh, so he really does play Palutena. Of course, he has more experience with this character, but
to counter Rob's projectiles, I don't know, with the reflector.
Yeah, I mean, Palutena used to be his go-to pick, so that's probably today he feels more comfortable on her, and that's why he plays her probably.
And we start on Smashville.
Yeah. You see him always trying to go for the near strings because they do so much damage.
But a quite defensive start from both of the players.
Yeah.
I mean, Rob can afford it.
Yeah, as Rob, you kind of want to play defensive with
a nice neutral air into double up air.
That was a misinput.
And a quite good start from Vilugi for sure. Because he gets his nairs again and nair.
So scary when the gyro is out on stage, but. Not really in a threatening position right there. The side B.
Yeah, mistimed side B, but...
But it wouldn't kill anyway, so... Yeah.
But it was safe because it didn't get punished and it was... So you can try it.
Juggling with the gyro, really.
Slowly Alex is bringing this whole thing back and now it's even
and
again.
And the back air almost really
so close. Yeah. If you had a little bit more rage, it would have killed. Oh, nice spot dodge read.
Yeah.
It's the up smash.
Up smash, not a move that you see that often on stage.
But it's...
Yeah, it's...
This time the back air kills, yeah.
It's used a lot for...
Ledge trapping.
Two framing.
Maybe.
Yeah, and ledge trapping.
And it's the up smash with the longest reach, probably. I don't know about Simon's, but it's...
Yeah.
It's close.
Nice near.
Again, Palutena's
gonna be
best
a lot of damage. Yeah.
Back again.
It
was this time
a really good jump read. Yeah.
It has such a weird hitbox.
It's so huge for Alex right now that he got the kill so early.
And spot dodge. Off stage,
trying to go for the head down. Yeah,
scary.
Yeah. Back here.
You don't want to be under the stage against a character like Rob because of down air and many other tools that he has.
That's
true. Oh, nice setup, almost. If you roll to the right, he would have got.
Whoa! That was the
again. He tried gyro into down air and now he gets down smash. It was immense pressure. And
yeah.
So well deserved first game victory.
Yeah.
And now we will see if he sticks with Palutena or maybe switches to Greninja.
Yeah. Maybe he switches.
I don't know.
So Pokemon
it looked
Stadium
good at the beginning, but then the lead is slowly faded away. So
yeah. So we are going to PS2, and yeah, he's. I don't know. Maybe he's thinking about it.
He is thinking for sure,
but he stays Palutena.
Yes. I mean, with best of five, you can afford to maybe adapt one more game, and if it doesn't pay out again, then you switch.
I think so we jump right into the second game.
And a very good start from Alex.
Yeah, this time. But Veloci brings it back with
up air strings.
Really nice up air strings. Yeah.
Sorry.
Getting the spot dodge lead right there. And
It looks similar to last game, right? They both were 90% really? Or so, and
then the back
exactly
yeah.
like
but
last time. Back air and it almost killed, but
what was that for a hitbox? It kind of
it
launched
really
him
weird,
up.
Yeah, it launched him upwards and then with the up air Rob got the kill. If it's exactly the same as last time, we will soon see an up smash from Veloge. So let's see. This happens.
That would be funny, but yeah, let's see.
But Alex
the pressure
is
from
doing
Alex
a
is
good job
right
with racking up damage and waited out the counter, but didn't get that many follow-ups.
Back air.
This time, back air from Palutena killed, yeah. It was really important for Veloge because again, the pressure from Alex is immense. So Veloge just tries to get back to the center of the stage, but it's not that easy. But now he caught him with the neutral air. And again, the back air, yeah.
I mean, those back airs are so strong and gets the kill.
Most of the kills are with back airs.
Yeah,
but
you gotta have a good read on the opponent in order to hit those big airs. So really good stuff from Alex. And again, with big air.
Now we don't see this side breeze from Rob so often, at least in
because
these
I think Palu is really a character which you cannot gimp that easily off stage. And that's actually where Rob is really good. So
there's the up smash.
F-tilt. Gonna get punished.
Yeah, punished for the F-tilt.
F-tilt's not
a bad
one of
move,
the.
But
yeah,
also
but
not
really
best,
safe. And forward.
Forward air. So actually, forward air and back air from Palutena look pretty similar, but.
Yeah, but back air is a lot stronger.
Yeah. Forward air this time also.
Was enough to
the job, yeah. And now with those strings, Veloge tries to bring it back and it doesn't look that bad.
I mean,
wow,
Alex was in a really
he
huge lead, but
gyro with the F-tilt.
Could be a nice comeback from Veloci. And he actually reflects the gyro.
The reflector came out really late, but it nice. And now Alex is trapped. So he got. I thought it was a confirm, but now he
And just the raw up smash was a nice call.
You didn't expect it because he didn't do up smash at all in these two games, right?
Yeah.
And then you just
and
throw it out.
What I'm catching on is like Alex doesn't do grabs that often, so I actually didn't see a single grab from him.
I mean, in the beginning, I think yes, but now with the late percents, not really.
I mean, grab into down into down.
Down throw into up air, right?
Yeah, but he didn't go for those confirmed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right. I think. Let's see, he sticks with Palutena. Maybe
and
because
Pokemon Stadium too.
Yes.
So yeah.
Because the last game was much closer than the first one in the end, so maybe he can bring it back.
Yeah.
But it's a 2-0 deficit
and
now.
That was a really nice combo from Veloci.
Yes. Veloci with the slightly better start.
Yeah, they're not like pushing it so hard, so they're kind of.
Oh wow! What a setup! Gyro into.
That was actually down insane. Yeah.
I mean, Veloci was in the lead all the time, and now
he knew that the gyro would.
Sick.
And
now it looks like Alex is all over the place.
Yeah, he's really feeling himself right now. Get going for those crazy combos.
Now he did
again
grab,
and
right?
Again. Yeah.
And the momentum has shifted totally. Yeah. You can see it already 100% again, so.
Oh, the ledge canceled.
Yeah, from the Palutena special. Oh, and this time he gets caught in the
and
explosive flame. Finally, yeah. Yes.
Yeah, that's something you have to be aware of all the time when being off stage that Palu's again
set up with the gyro.
The back, yeah.
Back air, yeah.
And now Veloci is on his last stock.
It's so difficult for him now because.
Yeah.
Yes.
But I mean, he could bring it back, but the momentum is totally not in his.
Yeah, but he did. Look at this, he's.
Yeah, he just killed.
He gets robbed
without
last
taking too much damage, then. Yeah. He could probably get it back.
But now, 50% with 1-2 combos, that's a lot. I think Alex tries to go for the fancy stuff now. Gets many really nice setups. And back again
back
for
back
the 6th, 7th time or so, but doesn't kill quite yet.
And more back air again.
Yeah, yeah, he goes for those back airs. The next back air would kill for sure.
Yeah.
Oh, the gyro. Yeah, he caught the gyro and threw it back. And that's scary. I saw the gyro and I knew
there's not much you can do.
Yes. Well, the gyro is right there.
Yeah, the gyro at the ledge is really, really scary.
Alex played really good. And a convincing 3-0. The second one it is top 32.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And
so we will see what game we will have next. What
so
match?
Clemens.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah. we will see Wick against Luigi player next. Wick definitely the favorite in this.
Yes, Wick won against Rayo in the first round. He's from Salzburg. He traveled there and then played against Wick and then lost. And he also won against Luigi Kid.
Oh yeah.
But Luigi Kid is still in the top 32, so in the loser side.
I mean, Luigi Kid and he's playing so well. The past few months,
yeah.
He has improved really, really a lot.
And Luigi Kid also played really well on stream today.
Yeah.
Against Tuni.
And, of course, Luigi Player, who we will see right now against Wick, right?
Yes.
He always gets mixed up with Luigi Kid. Because they have so similar
Luigi
names.
Player doesn't play Luigi anymore.
Luigi Kid staying true to his name.
Yes.
I love the dedication from him.
So Luigi Player is cleaning his hands and preparing.
Yeah, getting ready for the match.
and Wick with the hoodie. And here you can take a look into the venue. Yeah. A lot of people today.
It's a really nice venue. I mean, it's not the place where it was planned to be.
It was a spontaneous change, but it still works out.
Yeah, well. It's still a nice venue, definitely.
Yes. And Vic is promoting VCA.
Yeah, we just heard a huge announcement. MK Leo is coming.
MK Leo is coming to Vienna on 23rd and 24th.
Leute, mach mal ein bisschen Hype. MK Leo kommt nach Wien.
MK Leo! Yeah, I think they didn't hear us.
They didn't hear us, but the crowd went crazy when the video was shown.
It's gonna be all over Twitter.
Yes. I mean, Mr. R is also coming, and Mero is also coming, and probably some other top players will follow.
I'm expecting Plutoni also to come.
Yes. So 23rd, 24th November.
That's a date you have to put into your calendar.
Yes.
And fun fact, VCA will actually be in the same building as we are right now, but it's like down there and it's a huge hall. Gonna be amazing, gonna be amazing. And LP, he goes DK.
Yeah,
DK, definitely interesting to watch because I mean, almost all the heavies are really interesting to watch. They are combo foods on the one hand, but on the other hand, they can get the kills so early and can set up high plays.
Mm-hmm.
And Rick playing Joker.
Yeah, so we go right into the first game. Again, Pokémon Stadium 2. Luigi player starts with charging his.
That's a classic
punch
move from DK. Always threatening to have a charged mutual B.
Mm. He tries to go for the important grabs, but.
Yeah, but.
Yes, no, in the third try he gets it.
And nice
a scene is almost already up.
You really want
look
to
at
end
this, how
him
much
here.
How much damage? 74%.
Big air of Asin is so
I don't
strong.
Know why he went for the counter.
Oh, it was the re-grab and unfortunate that he didn't get the second hit of down beat.
Oh, and this gets punished hard, the high recovery.
Oh, he actually doesn't go for the down air.
But yes, with the help of Asin.
Asin ran out.
Yes.
And
this could be the
this
kill.
This is
the
first stock,
It's really so difficult to get out of it because you can mash as hard as you want, but it's just carries you off stage.
Yeah. Actually, up B out of shield.
Yes, but
it's very punishable. But if you don't
connect
expect it, yeah.
Oh, and this time it connected. So LP is still living with 160%.
Getting those up B's.
And it's lucky that Asin isn't out yet, because even a back air at 180% doesn't kill. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Another back air. And now Asin is there and. And Wick has to get the kill now,
nice
and he does.
But he goes a lot for the falling neutral B. Directed downwards, like he just did, and then he cancels it somehow and does other attacks out of it, and it's actually such a good option. Players don't expect it because they drop the shield and then get hit by it.
Mm.
But now Vic has evened it up and
but his meter is also empty, so LP has some time to breathe and maybe get the kill now!
Oh, that was a really early kill.
Yes. The smash 4 combos.
The ding dong.
Expand the dong. Nice spot dodge into up tilt.
I mean, when you're not having a scene.
Again, the grab into the up. Yeah.
Yeah. When you don't have a scene, you have to go for the drag down combo in order to get a kill. Because a raw back air only kills off stage. And but with a scene, the whole game changes and it's. Yeah, you can get a kill with back air.
We got this kill because Azin almost ran out.
And another back air. Can he make it back?
Oh, yes. Really good really use close. Of neutral B to get back. And then the grappling hook. And yeah, LP definitely has the advantage here. And the up tilt.
Wow,
really strong.
A thing that I learned today is that the up tilt actually has a tipper. So on his hand, he has a lot more knockback.
But he would have killed anyways at this percent, I think. 130, yeah, so yeah.
Probably.
Now let's see if Wick stays with Joker or if he switches, because
he also has a wolf, right?
He has 10 characters that he can play.
Yeah, he's one of the
most versatile.
Yeah, most versatile players out there.
Yeah. When you're at the very top, you can afford to
have many characters.
Yes. When you are not as good, then maybe you just want to invest in one character so that you
learn
can
the
get
combos
to the top
and all the stuff. But he sticks to Joker.
It's Joker, yeah. Again, Pokémon Stadium, and again battled
the same music.
This time was the better start from Wick.
Yeah, really good start.
And the charge
73%.
And again, look at this. This could be a zero to death, almost a nice ledge jump. Yeah. I think there is hardly any player better at ledge jumping than Wick in Austria.
Yeah, for sure. He is so good.
And in Smash 4, nice 2-3 back as he tries it, but
he comes with it.
Yes, managed just to get back. Feel some.
This Joker is looking sick, really, really good.
Yes, this time back air.
It was a clean stock.
And just transitions right into a scene.
Oh man, those forward airs.
Yes, so good. Luigi player has to survive these last seconds, and now Azin is gone, so. Oh,
and
unfortunate
air dodge.
This was.
Yes.
This was not planned.
Definitely not planned, yeah.
Because Rick was nowhere there, he was at the left side.
And Rick living at 164%. 46%.
But now he's dead, so. Yeah, without the SD it would have looked much better, but now he has to try the best, but it will be really difficult. But he gets those grabs, so. But Wick gets out with the.
All, leads into a lot of damage from. Huge roll the last sec to avoid the neutral B. And double.
I didn't recognize that it already killed.
Yeah, it didn't look like a kill because you.
I didn't hear it.
You don't see that often side B killing.
Yeah, two side Bs in a row and he was gone. Poof.
It's actually really sick from from Wick.
And now it's 1-1 and yeah, it was a good decision to stick with the Joker. Maybe just the first game wasn't that good, but.
Yeah, he's definitely coming back from the first game in a huge way.
Yes. And now let's see which stage Luigi player picks. Smash Bash. So the players in this top 32 are sticking with their characters. Velogi stick with Palutena. And Vic stick with Joker and also the other ones. Again, a good start from Vic.
Really nice early combo from Vic.
And again, now Luigi player gets the grab, but yes, I wanted to say only one small combo, but it's still a 32%, so
yeah.
Not too bad.
Nice shield and right out.
And he tries to go for the back air. You all saw it, Azin is there.
And now Azin is out and it suddenly it becomes really scary for each player.
Oh, nice counter.
It was a really good counter.
Tetracon was important. And he can still use Azin to...
Yeah, those neutral B cancels are so...
To get some
so
more
good.
Damage. Look at this, 52%.
And now...
And this Joker looks much better than from the first game. So
yeah. Wick in a whole stock lead. It's gonna be hard for Luigi player to come back.
He always gets his counters to fill up the meter.
Oh, gets the roll read with up tilt.
Yes, it's up tilt covers some options, I think.
Yeah, and you can react to the roll really good with up tilt.
Yeah. Oh wow, that
the
was
the classic.
A nice confirm. The drag down up air into smash attack.
Yeah.
Doesn't get the follow-up, but we are only seconds away from Azin coming back.
Ooh, does not neutral B. Doesn't get punished.
But maybe he can get at least some very good percent.
I feel like
again it had
the counter.
And down air.
Yes.
Nice
spike.
Counter into
that was really good.
Into
but
down air.
With Donkey Kong, it's you can't really do much if you recover from
that's
down below.
Problem, yeah.
You're so vulnerable at the top, and any character that has a good downward spike just can spike spike him.
Donkey Kong has good horizontal range, but not vertical. So,
and he's also really vulnerable at the top.
Luigi
is he
player
considering
now, I think.
A switch?
I don't know. I think
Wii Fit Trainer.
He will stick with Donkey Kong.
I could see him changing because he lost
to
two
whom?
Times in a row.
Mewtwo?
Mewtwo?
Mewtwo? No way.
No. No.
Yes.
Okay.
I mean,
but those last two games were really convincing from Wick. That's
yes.
That's why I probably thought that he was considering the switch. But
yeah, I don't know why he used the punch.
Yeah,
maybe it was accidental. But
ooh, nice
oh.
Pivot grab
yes.
from Luigi there.
And again, waiting out the counter and grabbing.
It doesn't go for the upper, but for the two back airs. It was a very clever decision.
Yeah, and Wick is already at 80-90%, so of course he also has a scene now. Egger is so damaging.
Yeah.
It brings but everything back with a
yeah,
scene,
a pretty
so.
Even start of the fourth game.
I mean, it looked better for Luigi player in the beginning for the first time, I think.
Yeah. And the back
this
yeah. It was really
set. Yeah.
Yeah, he was in a good
immediately
position.
Immediately the up tilt. Yeah. So up tilt is the most common kill move in this set, I think, from Donkey Kong from Luigi player.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this could be a really exciting game four. Because look, it looks like Luigi player is. Figuring out how to
yeah,
do damage.
Catching up, definitely.
And now he again catches him on the platform. falling there. Wow, he waited what Wick will do, but he missed just barely. Nice down there, and...
But can't confirm it into anything. But this
time,
was
yes.
a good confirm.
Very nice. Down B into up air.
A down B is actually a really good option in this game. To
one of the many spikes from Donkey Kong. Luigi player goes for the high recovery and it paid off this time.
Ooh, and breakdown, but misses somehow the...
That's actually... It looked funny, Donkey Kong just jumped a little bit.
Yeah, that's actually a thing.
Wow!
Almost, this would have been so high.
But he lost his stock for it.
Yes, but I mean, he was at high percent.
Yeah,
anyway,
it was a nice try from him. And
this would have been so high. But still, Luigi player.
Wow! And he gets
there
up
was
there.
Again. This was a crazy set. A crazy game from Luigi player this time.
So much.
And now we have a game 5 situation. And that's what we want to see here.
Yeah, and we're going to a game 5.
Yes, yeah. And it was good that he didn't switch because I don't think with another character he would have.
Yeah, probably a good decision from him. And we go to Battlefield.
We can choose the stage, but Battlefield.
I think Pokémon Stadium is not bad for Joker at all. Because
it's maybe the best stage for Joker.
Yeah,
to
because
be
you see the drag down combos, they work so
and
good.
And I think
at the
Battlefield
stage.
Is also quite good for. Donkey Kong,
yeah,
with all
Donkey
the
Kong
grabs and then into up air. Now let's see who will win this game 5.
Yep.
And this time with a better start for
up B. Wow,
crazy
nice
combo
use of up B from Wick
to start off the game, but only 34%, so still nothing has happened. And now DK starts
neutral into up B.
The center. Let's get up into immediate up tilt again. And
that was really nice drag down again.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they look so stylish when you get them.
Yes. High recovery again.
High recovery,
but this
gets
time
punished.
It's
right.
Punish,
yeah. You see how weak those smash attacks actually are without.
Oh wow, nice back air.
Oh my god, man.
This was a crazy comeback, and just at the time when he got a scene, this was a kill at the perfect moment for Lucifer. And I think we got caught off guard.
And suddenly it.
Yes, 194% now it's.
But it looked so good for Luigi player.
Yes, and I mean, it still looks good considering the bad start from him.
Yeah. If Luigi player manages to take this game, it's a huge upset. We have to say it.
Yes. Now, a scene,
spot dodge.
But
again.
I don't think he will die yet.
We just heard Syndro won 3-0 against.
That's
True
crazy,
four.
Yes.
Oh wow!
Oh.
And you don't expect
this game is also crazy, yeah. So we have to focus on this for the moment and can later talk about True 4 and Syndro. Because we just saw an unfortunate. So first we saw an unfortunate kill.
But the up air, I mean, who would expect that you have to take it?
So LP first died, unfortunate, but then he.
Yeah.
Got this crazy
oh
kill
my
and
god,
Vic
oh
didn't
my
ca-
god.
And now it's really scary because
I thought for sure the up air.
Yes, the up air would be
and
back air. Back air! There it is! And this is
oh my god.
3-2. we all saw it coming and there it was and Vic is
such good play from Luigi player.
And acknowledges the
and actually
huge achievement from Luigi player.
As we just heard before. Another huge upset was happening.
Yes.
True 4 lost.
Yeah,
True 4 lost against Syndro. And this one, so both So both Wick and True 4 are in losers bracket.
So maybe they will meet each other there. So because Wick is also one of the favorites to win the win the turn, or at least plays top three. He always places top five, top three.
And
he also won one of
so right now we are getting Raban against Raban, Clemens on stream, and yeah, it's gonna be an awesome set as well.
Yes,
I'm predicting.
I would have loved to see Syndro versus
Truth War.
I like to call Syndro the Shulk Slayer because he also
won against you.
He won against me on stream. He won against who was it? Stray Dog on
Stray
stream
Dog,
today.
Yeah. Oh,
he slays all the Shulks. Yes, and Raban versus Clemens is a classic. Two top five players in Austria.
Yeah.
I will take a look at the bracket.
Raban actually also won
one of the Breakpoint
tournaments. Yeah.
Yes. And I mean Clemens got second last time, I think. Only lost against Longo and won against Vic in the losers final.
Yeah.
Yes, and Syndro won against Trufa in a convincing fashion. It was a 3-0. So it was not close.
It was not close.
And we will see Syndro versus the winner of Clemens. Yeah, Clemens, I wanted to say.
Clemens.
Of Clemens versus Raban.
But this is gonna be top 8, right? So.
Yes.
Not right now, but. Afterwards in top 8. As we dive just right into the game.
Yes, we see the color yellow is very.
Golden shower inking, yeah.
Very present here. And it's a good start from Raban. He inked Clemens and already wrecked out 82% damage. And Raban always wants to improve. He says his inkling can still do much better.
But almost out of ink right now. So probably
yes, but we also saw Space at the French tournament and he was out of ink so many times but still managed to get the kills. Yeah. And but now Clemens
got the kill with the forward air.
Yes. Oh, very nice. Almost the kill with the throw into
up throw into up air.
Yeah.
And the roller actually the knockback hit.
Yeah,
so
it was the aerial roller.
Yeah.
So.
Weird addiction with
Mountain. Clemens plays
and
really good now.
Doesn't get the tech chase.
Because he could. Clemens almost could get this two stock lead if he lands a forward air or something like this.
Nice down smash. As we say with the down smash. Raban gets the kill, but it was really a struggle to get this one kill. And.
Almost a turn.
Yeah, with another character. Wouldn't have made it back, but Inkling's recovery is really good, so no problems for him.
Yes. Finally get some color.
Yeah.
Raban is still living, so okay, this was one too much.
Yeah.
Nice combo, but doesn't connect.
Yeah,
so only
24%.
But it still looks really good for Clemens, and Raban has to maybe
Raban
change
really
the strategy.
Raban really can't get out of the ledge situation.
Yes.
Because Clemens, especially with Peach, is so good at ledge trapping. And I'm just feeling his struggle right now.
And
nice.
Forward
air.
Yeah. Just enough to.
That was really convincing.
First game,
in my opinion.
It was a two stock, right?
A two stock.
So, not a bad start at the beginning of the game from Raban, but then Clemens turned up the fire, turned up
and
the heat.
Raban really had no chance of getting out of back from the ledge to center stage. It's
especially at the end so of the
difficult for him. Oh, we actually
get to see the Robin. Love to see the Robin. Yeah. Mama's Robin is really cool.
And Clemens is definitely a character which is nice to watch.
Yes, and Clemens also switches up the character, if you want to say so. That's with Daisy instead of Peach. Thunder.
I'm sure you find this.
Nice catch from the turnip, and he can use it to his advantage.
Nice parry on the arc fire.
But it's not easy because Clemens plays really good again.
Yeah.
Raban doesn't play bad, but Clemens just gets more of these important hits of this damage. And the snipe is not enough yet, but maybe the fall.
Yeah, the near.
Yeah, neutral air is also enough. Nice.
I mean, it's so good just floating on the ledge. And
it's 11 sword.
He doesn't have a hitbox, and that's easy.
Raban has 11 sword, so he gets some more damage, which is important.
Oh. And
nice.
The up, yeah. But yeah, not in kill percent yet.
Now the 11th sword is gone, but Raban can still work with projectiles and
yeah.
Now it's back again. That was quick.
Oh, unfortunate.
I mean,
dodge back, but
nothing happened, so.
Yeah, but it was a scary situation for sure.
Yeah.
Oh, the re-grab! Oh, wow, almost. But yeah, not really.
Arc fire! It was so close. Arc Thunder, I mean.
At the third hit,
the jab. Yes,
yeah.
Third hit.
So he didn't do the rapid jab.
Yeah.
Actually did the three times jab.
Wow. Almost. And again, the turnip.
Raban living up to.
What was that?
I have no idea what.
Maybe he ran out of. I don't know.
No, I don't think so. Maybe he just missed.
I didn't see it. It was just too far below the ledge.
Really nice float, stalling.
Yeah, interestingly, both of these players don't play with headphones, so they absorb the whole atmosphere. And it doesn't bother them in the slightest, and there it still isn't enough, but it was a really good smash attack.
Oh, and you see Clemens was
trying to confuse the opponent with some mix-ups in the umbrella recovery, but
yeah. But I feel like this
Raban
could have beat
this stock.
But now with
last stock situation, so who knows what happens.
But still, I mean,
for the first
a
time
huge
went
mount
for
to climb for Raban.
Yeah. Raban went for Nosferatu.
Yeah,
but didn't get it.
Oh, nice.
Double up, yeah? Yeah, again, Nosferatu, but it's a really good move because you can heal yourself and the opponent gets damaged. And
it's really unique. It acts like a grab, but.
And also, Nosferatu in Fire Emblem Awakening is one of the best moves in the game. And there
the and hitbox kind of gets extended.
Yeah. The Clemens back air, maybe the best kill move from Peach and Daisy.
Yeah, and forward air, of course, also.
Yeah, forward air.
But it's,
of course, it's
you
stronger.
You have to get. It comes out later.
Back air comes out faster.
It's stronger.
Oh. You can float into back air.
And goes back again to Peach.
Always another costume. In the first one it was the black yellow costume, and this time it's the pink one.
Yeah.
So a good start from Clemens
again. Oh, and he doesn't grab the ledge.
Grab the ledge, but I think he maybe didn't want to, but Peach is so fast, she can punish you really easily. And now it's looking better for Raban because he got some nice...
Wow,
that actually killed. Crazy.
Yeah. Up, yeah.
And my fully charged forearm 17% in this case. I mean, it didn't hit in the middle, but nice DI from Raban to survive this. And maybe he can get the first game finally to make it 2-1.
Yeah, I mean, he's in a nice lead.
Yeah,
right now.
Those he got three up airs.
Yeah,
in
those up airs are really good. And
he ran out of
the magic. Yeah, of the magic lead. Yeah. Oh, nice catch again.
Yeah, again
he has the sword in the hand.
Yes,
so,
and yes, he threw it, but now it's.
And again, the ledge trapping from Clemens.
Again, the back air, the most common kill move.
But I mean, Robin can take this.
Oh wow, why didn't it connect? It looked like finally Nosferatu
was working, but yeah.
Nice Sauron. It's the kill, and now it's a one-stock lead.
Yeah, but.
Wow, what
really
a combo!
There was
almost zero
to
death.
Almost zero
to crazy.
Death. It was nice.
We just said it was a one-stock lead.
Yeah,
and
it was
five
a huge lead.
5 seconds later, it was over.
He equalized it, and now he has actually taken the lead.
Yeah,
so Clemens. Oh, that's a huge punish for Raban.
It's crazy how fast the game has shifted, and now look at this. Clemens brought it all back and is only one forward air or
the
back air
was
the ledge
so
away
close
from
away
taking
from
this game.
But Raban can bring it back if he. Oh, it was
Nosferatu
a bad
again.
Nosferatu. And back air again.
Yeah, those back airs are so fast. You
the weak hitbox.
Oh, the turn is time.
But
and
it's,
this will
it's not over.
The
and
the
air.
Yes, nice takes. Really, really good stuff from Clemens.
Clemens
and he takes
it
3-0.
3-0 again.
Yeah. Third one was pretty close, but he got some really nice conversions. And
and the last stock from Clemens was really nice.
Yeah, and this means Clemens will play against Sintro in top 8. And next we have Dimikiev versus.
Oh, so this is loser side right now?
Yes, now it's loser side. And we have Dimikiev versus Sykes.
Ah, that's gonna be an interesting one as well.
Because Dimikiev got upset
by
Shocker, right?
Shocker, yeah.
Yes.
That's actually a huge upset.
But Dimikiev did well in the loser side. Mm-hmm. And we can see it in the bracket. He won against Stray Dog, the Shulk, won against Sanzi.
Against Sanzi.
But really close, 3-2. Yeah. So.
And now we see him playing
against Sykes. And Sykes also played really well today. He knocked out Coolman, actually.
Oh yeah,
so that's also really nice. Sykes won 3-1 against Heck and 3-1 against Coolman, and now he faces Dimiki.
Heck no slouch either. He's really with his Mii Swords Fighter.
Yeah,
also one of the
a unique pick. Sykes, the Sunny Boy.
Sunny Black.
Oh,
he already
has the name, so just wants to double check it or maybe adjust some controls.
Yeah.
So let's take a look at the bracket while the players are working the setup up. Vilogi won against Shiggy 3-0.
Okay.
And Shiggy won against Nerox before, but. Sandro won against Deluxe, but then lost against Fies. So Sandro is knocked out in the losers round. And
Veloci has to play against
Fies. Yeah. And the winner of Veloci versus Fies will play against Trufor, and this will also be on stream. So we will see another Trufor match on stream. And then we have Bassi, who got knocked out by Trufor, as we have seen. And a very close one against Veno, the Link main from Upper Austria, 3-2. And Bassi also won against Raffioli, 3-0. So he will play next against Alex. So he's actually right now playing. So we will see how this turns out.
Yeah.
Yes. And now back into the game is Captain Falcon versus Ken.
Captain Falcon, one of the most entertaining characters to watch.
Yes, we have many Captain Falcons today here.
Yeah.
Also, we saw Mercy earlier on screen.
And Wutanfall also. Yes.
Good start from Sykes, but here we see the Ken combos. And I think Dimiki is also really excited for the next DLC character, which will come in November. Oh, nice, Shoryuken.
But it's not gonna kill
yet, yeah.
But the next one will for sure.
Yes, he tries it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah,
seven.
There was nothing Sykes could do. I mean, if he held on to shield, it would have been broken,
yeah.
For sure. And yeah, there was no way.
Yeah. Currently, he looks a bit helpless against all these crazy combos because not everyone plays Ken, and
yeah.
It's probably the most difficult character in the game, I would dare to say.
Oh, really nice, man.
2-0, and Dimiki only got 27.
Yeah, I mean,
and also in the beginning,
looks so
again
good
the combos. Look
right
at
now.
The time, it's only 1 minute played and it's almost over.
I think he wanted to go for the down air, yeah, for the high play. But yeah, still only 27% on Dimitri's side.
This looks like a really good 3-stock, but now finally Sykes gets some.
Oh, sure you.
And Shoryuken! 3-0 and only 59% taking the.
A free stock
the freshman 60.
Wow.
We will see how will Sykes recover from this.
Yeah.
I mean, I think we will stick with Captain Falcon.
Yeah, I don't think he has a pocket pick.
No, this was really, really good.
Yeah. We can. Oh, wow.
Okay, he actually changes to Snake.
So this free stock actually forced him to change the character. And we see Snake on Battlefield. A stage which is definitely good for Snake. And yeah, Dimitri told me that Ken has a lot of trouble against campy characters. Mm. That's probably why Sykes went to Snake. And you see it already.
Yes.
Already more percent than
I know. I know.
Whole
20
last
seconds
game.
Play and already better than last game. Hadouken for 6 times in a row.
Yeah, but yeah, he doesn't want to approach Dimitri.
Yeah.
Because it's also hard.
And this.
Whoa, what? That was the timing. There
was
the 30-second timing of C4, which was
oh,
on
nice.
The platform.
Do you think Dimitri calculated this? It would be really crazy.
I don't think so, but
if he just knew it will explode now and I will delay.
Oh, he got the sticky on the top.
Oh my god. So we got 2 really hype kills at the beginning, and now it's a really exciting match to watch, even though it's very defensive still. But it doesn't look like Smash Bros. Actually, but.
Oh, there was actually C4 laying.
Yeah, and it's really impressive how calm Sykes right now is after this 3-stock.
Yeah, after this destruction.
Doesn't kill yet, but high recovery again from Sykes, and you saw the C4.
C4 is in top platform, so
yes.
Dimitri has to be aware of it.
But I think he is.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Gets the F smash punish. Yeah. Sykes can just crawl under the Hadouken. That's what he.
I thought he will remotely activate the C4, but.
Yeah, C4 is still on the top platform,
yeah,
and now
it explodes.
Yeah,
it's 30 seconds, right?
Yeah, 30 seconds, and then it will explode.
Oh,
nice read on the.
But
the roll
isn't
out.
The kill, I thought it would be.
Oh,
wow, he got out of
his
up here again, and the third hype kill in a row. So this
was
game
just
is
so good. Reacting on the grenade and where he was,
yeah.
And that he wasn't in hit stun anymore.
So if you just
nice
turned on now, you
have missed
one.
A lot.
you're watching probably the best game in this tournament so far because you never know what happens with all those projectiles and fancy combo stuff.
Nice evading the.
Yes, 181% grenade. Nice.
Whoa.
But it doesn't kill yet.
Doesn't kill.
How
really
how heavy
lucky
is
for
how heavy is Ken? That's crazy. 200%.
Oh,
nice parry end. This time
the down air out of shield.
The fastest move out of shield from Snake.
Yes.
Oh yeah. One, I think even the fastest down in the game, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay.
Yeah, and Sykes can bring it back, especially with Snake. Snake,
yes, can rack up damage so quickly.
Yeah,
and now
can,
look
he
at
can
this,
lift
58% and 57%, so it's damn close.
Oh, that didn't hit.
Yeah, the C4, a bit lucky for Ken, but
down it. And the grenades. Just shield is really low for Dimitri right now. Okay, just relaxing on the top platform. Oh,
yeah.
I thought maybe he wants to go for the.
Yes, and now
sure you can.
Again. And this ends this crazy game too. And we have a 2-0 lead, but don't be misled because Sykes played really, really well, especially after going down 3-0. It's so impressive that he.
The snake definitely gave him confidence, and I think this third game will be really exciting to watch.
Yeah, because of Snake. It would be even more crazy if he now changes the character again,
yeah.
But I don't think so. Or will he?
He will go for the snake. Snake.
What?
No way, no way.
Maybe he.
I mean, he got destroyed so badly.
Yeah, but maybe he wanted to prove that he isn't that bad with Captain Falcon, that it was just a one-time slip.
Yeah, but I mean, he has proven so by getting so far in the tournament.
Yeah.
I mean, his Captain Falcon is really good, but
yeah.
Just in this matchup, he had a really hard time to.
A good start from Dimitri this time.
72% right off the bat. And yeah.
So, and you know, we are
snake
in losers right now, so the losers of this round will get
eliminated.
Knocked out of the tournament.
I'm sure you can. But
not
Snake
yet, yeah?
Lives it.
Wow,
it was really optimistic.
This time the Shoryuken.
Yeah, I mean, you can. It's not that unsafe because it's hard to punish Shoryuken, even the landing.
Yeah.
So. Actually, a really good move. A really good kill move.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, huge percent for Dimitri.
Yes. And Sykes has to get the kill now because.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if because Snake has on some characters he has frame advantage on down. On down throw that
with full rage will kill
that he
much
can
earlier,
kill with and sticky. He got the sticky.
Yes. Yeah.
So that's a really difficult situation for Dimitri to win.
Oh,
but
wow.
He actually shields it.
Yes.
And this this looks.
It was
much more like the first game than the second one. So could this be another 3-stock? This would be crazy again. So,
on sure
yes,
you can.
And it is.
And with the rage.
3-stock. That's so crazy.
Yeah.
The first game was a 3-stock. The second one was so close. And the third game was again a 3-stock.
I mean, Dimitri
won 3-0. But don't be fooled. I mean, the second game.
Yeah, but on the other
really
hand, the first and the third one were very convincing from Dimitri. Yes. And as we already said,
True 4
against Vilogi.
Yeah.
This will be the last game from this top 32.
Yeah,
and afterwards we will already see top 8, but first a break and then top 8.
Yeah, so the last game that from top 32 that we will broadcast until
True 4 is under pressure right now because he's expected to place high. He's expected to get into the finals, but
I mean,
he
came all the way from Germany, of course, to win.
Yeah, and his other German colleague last month, Longo, Yeah, he already
won
and destroyed everyone here.
Yeah.
So and Truth War is actually he is expected to be better than Longo even.
Yeah.
So
he is better. Yeah.
Really a surprise that he lost 3-0 against
Syndro before. Slayer. But I'm curious what Vilogi will pick, because I think Schulke has maybe even more trouble with Greninja than with Palutena. I know
Palutena
might be controversial, I think Palutena is a better matchup for Schulke than Greninja. At least from my experience, I play much better.
And we really do see the Greninja.
Yes. I play much better against Palutena than against Greninja, because Greninja is so freaking fast, and with his uppie he can actually gimp Schulke's uppie, so with the water.
Oh yeah, when he doesn't sweet spot the ledge.
And I think Greninja is a better choice here. And Greninja is also top tier, so.
Yeah, that's gonna be a huge punish in F smash. And
so much percent. 95% is Buster paid out really well. And we have the battle Kahuna theme, my favorite from Pokemon.
Yeah, that's a really nice soundtrack. And yeah, really
he already goes for smash, so one F tilt or
really nice stuff from
up tilt
before
could be
seeing right now.
Not neutral yet though.
Yeah, the forward air, as you can see, it goes under the stage, so
yes,
it's actually a really nice move. But the back air,
he gets the roll
from ledge with the back air. I mean, it covers so
this
nicely.
Looks really good from Trufa so far. Vilogi couldn't get any hits, just some very small ones, and only 33%. There's Buster again, and
nice damage he got in
now
there.
Now he switches to shield as soon as he gets grabbed, as always. Nice air dodge from Vilogi to avoid the forward air. Because if you get forward air twice in a row, so...
Yeah, the side beat, he wants
to
get
the upbeat. This is the reason why... One of the reasons why Greninja is such a... I don't know, such a matchup.
Nice take.
Because Trufa only had 55% and... Vilogi caught this upbeat with the water, and it's so good.
But Trufa are still in the lead, so...
Yeah, a little bit, but I mean, look at this. 1-2 up airs in a row, and now it's even.
Yeah.
And
man, I can't get over it that MK Leo is coming to VCA. Man, that's
so nice. I hope 600 persons in total are coming to. Is the capacity, so
yeah, the cap.
Be quick to
register.
To register, yes. And look at this, Vilogi, huge shouts out to him, because he plays really, really well right now. And he's giving Trufa so much trouble. Just one more back air, and... There it is, the kill, and...
The back
actually,
end,
we have Vilogi in the lead.
Yeah, the lead, and
Vilogi has to be really careful, smash Monado. I'm telling you, this matchup is
good for Schulke.
Yes, it's one of my least favorite matchups with Schulke. It's at least in the top three of my least favorite matchups.
Okay,
alongside with Snake and Yoshi probably. And there is Becca in
interesting
smash Monado,
hitbox. Huh? Yeah, it was like not even it didn't even hit with his sword, but with his body.
Actually, in Smash 4, the hitbox was even bigger, because in Smash 4 you could hit back air with the front side, and it was air was better in Smash 4 a little bit. But I think here air is a little bit faster, and now it's
damage.
It looks good again for Trufa.
Oh, I thought he's going for the up B out of
here. Oh wow! Luckily, he went into shield, because without shield, who knows if this could have been the kill with Smash Monado.
Oh, the counter? But yeah.
Yeah, let's see. It's far from over, but there's a back air again. Whoa. So we saw two back air kills from Trufor in this game.
Yeah. But it was definitely close. So
it was very close.
Not easy for Trufor to get the first win here.
And I hope Vilogi will stick with Greninja and pick his favorite stage.
Kalos.
Carlos and the music champion.
But Carlos, not really a bad stage for Schulk either.
Yes, Carlos is a good stage for Schulk in my opinion.
Yeah, so the Greninja. Greninja was looking nice for him. Mm. So we saw him before playing Palutena, but I think his Greninja is also looking really nice.
A nice start with Speed Monado Art.
Jump
there's the bust up, but he doesn't get the kills, it seems. So he will switch soon to another Monado, Art and Shield Monado. So Buster didn't pay out, and now it's exactly the same percentage. Speed, of course, it's easier to.
There was a really
the
nice follow up from the neutral air into the grab.
Mm-hmm. Yes, with. Speed Monado Art gives you so much more follow-ups.
He tried to get it again, but his dash grab wasn't reaching far enough.
Yeah.
Veloci always trying to bring the small shurikens in because it's just chip damage that he gets with it.
He goes for the counter!
Oh, and the unfortunate miss input from
was
the down
it? What was it?
It was down air.
Okay.
And he suicide-sided. Definitely not what he wanted right there. They should take the forward air.
Yes.
But I mean, 68%, he's not in the danger zone right now, so down tilt, up smash wouldn't kill, and they should take forward air also not.
And now it's looking really good for Trufor.
Yeah.
One forward air could be it.
Oh, and the down air, he tried to get him.
So with these multi-hit moves like Greninja, you can change Monado midway, so you can get into shield like here.
Yeah.
And you saw Veloci going again for the water, so Shulk has, Trufor has to be very careful with the recovery.
If he catches
again,
him,
you just get knocked away. What you can also do is up B, up tilt, and also up B at the ledge.
Up tilt is.
Yeah,
you
this
saw
was
him.
A good counter. Yeah. He
up tilt
went for the up tilt.
Oh, nice. Up air. Immediate up air.
And actually, Schulk's up air is one of the strongest in terms of kill power.
Yeah, but it's so hard to get.
It's hard to get, but I think it's even the strongest. At least I saw some compilation video. Some test video or something like
that. Yeah.
Oh, he doesn't get the down throw into forward tilt.
Yeah.
But still, he's in a huge lead, so.
Yeah, up tilt is from Schulk is actually really good because if the opponent is above you, there's not much to.
Did you see it? This is what I said.
Oh my!
Up air is so ridiculous good.
Yeah.
You saw it with Smash Monado Art, it kills 70%.
He just gets them. It looks so easy, but it's really hard to get them. Trust me.
It's easier with Jump Monado Art when the opponent is above.
Yeah. I mean, is the Monado... how was it called in Smash 4 where you do the jump, the Monado Purge? Is it still a thing?
The Monado Purge... So in Smash 4, Monado Purge used to be a 50-50 kill confirm with Jump Monado Art.
And is it still a thing here? Or
no. Monado Purge is extinct. It doesn't exist anymore, but you can do it in a similar form. But okay, he goes.
And we actually see the switch right now from Veloci.
Yeah, Monado Purge doesn't exist anymore because it's not consistent. But I mean, you can still try to go for up throw into up air
yeah.
for the kills. But Actually, there are other really high technique stuffs like wheel cancelling, Monado.
Yeah, Monado dial storage. Dial
I mean,
dial
Monado landing leg, Monado art landing leg cancel is still a thing in Smash Ultimate, but not.
Yeah, overall.
You don't use it as often because the Monado dial switching is so much better than in Smash 4. So
overall, Schulk got better in Ultimate.
Yes, but some
stuff is
got nerfed. Like counter. And
like with most characters. Yeah.
But Schulk definitely a character who
it's
got
good start from 2-4 and with the up B. Yeah, the up B, the lingering up B when you're under the stage.
Yes, I love to do it. It's so good.
In the opposite way, then really catches a lot of up B's recoveries.
Yeah.
Yeah, and True 4 got a lot of damage in the last few seconds. Yeah.
But with Monado dial storage, you can do similar stuff. So,
so yeah, that was
it's not quite yet. But with the forward air, maybe you can.
Yeah. Velocity maybe thought.
Nice up smash, and this is the. And as I said, Palutena is not that bad for Schulk. I think Schulk maybe even wins this matchup.
It was still dangerous for True 4 to go for the Smash Monado because he was also in kill suit percent.
Yes,
but he has.
You normally only go into Smash Monado art when.
Yeah, he has a 2-stock lead,
know
so
that
he
you
can afford, afford it.
And huge punish again.
Yeah.
He went. He wanted a 3-stock, but I don't think the Smash deck was.
Yeah.
Of course, it wasn't the best choice, but it was a nice try, nonetheless.
But hard for Veloci to come back here in this tournament life.
And just to talk about Trufo, he placed really well in the last tournament, in the last major tournament in France. So he won against the likes of Mero, and he won against Ice Studying, and he won against Homika, and he placed.
Here you can see it. Here you see
that
the
was so nice and well executed. The down throw into the cancelled buster up.
Was it the dial storage?
Yes, I think it was the dial storage cancels. So he cancelled the buster. And so that he get the kill with the up B, because with Buster Art it wouldn't have killed.
Man, that was just a stylish finisher.
Yes.
And
as we expected, the Palutena was the Greninja was the better choice.
Yeah.
So this was the last.
Yeah, that was the last.
This was the last match in top 32, I think. But just stick one moment, so maybe we see another one. We'll just ask. But we can take a look at the bracket to see the results.
What matches we will see later on.
Yes. So, Sindro versus Clemens is one of the top 8 matches in winner's side.
Winner's
the
side
other one is Yeti versus Luigi player, who won against Wick. We saw that already. And Yeti won against Alex.
So, Sindro got sent into loser's bracket?
No, Sindro plays against Clemens.
Oh, Yeah, he won against True 4, of course.
Yes. And True 4 won against Velogi, but he will play against the winner of Raban versus Dimiki.
Okay.
So this will also be streamed in top 8. And the other one will be Alex versus Putzi. I mean, Alex versus Putzi are still playing.
Yeah. And.
Okay.
All right.
Vic.
Oh.
So we will have Vic versus Puchogi or expansion?
Yeah. So we will actually have one more game.
Yes.
Wick against the winner of
Puchogi. Yes, it would be cool to see Puchogi coming this far in the tournament.
Yeah.
Because Puchogi is quite an underrated player, he's really good.
Yeah, he's really good. And he also plays Ken, so
and no matter who advances, expansion or Puchogi, both would exceed the seed, if you can say this.
Yeah. I mean expansion plays Game & Watch, so character you also don't see that much. And
you only see Meister playing Game & Watch. So we will just wait for the match expansion versus, who was the other one?
Puchogi
to finish. And then we will see who will advance. But I can give a small live ticker if you want, because the match is right behind us. And it's Puchogi has 1 stock and expansion also has 1 stock, so it looks really like a close game.
I mean, Pachogi, you can see it right there.
Yes, Pachogi already has 100% and Expansion has 30%. So,
but we don't know which game it is.
Yeah,
so
maybe it's the last game already. So, but Pachogi is bringing it slowly back because Expansion already has 55% now.
Oh, he
and you know Shoryuken,
and he got the kill with.
Oh, he got the kill
and
with Shoryuken.
The
here's
pop
the
off.
Pop off from Pachogi, and
I mean
it
you
looks
can
like
see
he won.
Yeah, he won. So,
so we
nice
actually see another Ken. He looks really relieved. So I guess this was
yeah.
maybe a 3-2.
I mean, we will tell him that he will play on stream.
Pachogi, spielst jetzt
nice.
On stream gegen Wick.
Pachogi will play on stream.
Nice
but we commentated your game.
Yeah, from here.
Yeah, we looked at your game there and then we commented. We looked at your game here and commentated it because we are waiting for you.
Yeah. So nice.
Really nice.
Yeah, I mean, Pachogi won before against me, but it was also close.
Yeah, it was
2-1.
Yeah.
It was actually the last stop.
Pachogi is also the TO, right? Who does
yeah.
the seating and stuff. So he is a really cool guy.
Yeah, really nice dude. And also a good friend of Wick and C5. So
yeah. we will see who battles out the last place for top 8.
We see the snake tease. Of course, his old main. Or
I mean, maybe he plays
yeah.
him against Ken. I don't know. If
I mean, it's the character he played in the past the most, but then he played also a lot of Wolf and yeah, Joker, of course.
Yeah, and I think
and
you
a
can
lot
understand when yeah. you give Pachogi a small break after this intense set. Just to drink some water to collect himself and to
yeah,
be prepared.
He was so hyped and the pop off
yes.
also. Yeah, it's always understandable that you want to get a break and
yes,
it's hard
see
to
him doing this.
And it's hard to play right after
yeah,
having
and
such
and
a
you see Expansion here yeah. at the at our back, so
yeah.
he
but he
also,
performed really
yes.
nicely.
Coming so far and placing
yeah.
almost top 8 is.
I mean, he played Game & Watch, but he also played the new character Banjo.
Mm.
So also
yes.
cool seeing people picking him up
mm-hmm.
and just trying him out. But I don't know. I don't think Banjo is like a top tier character. It just has a lot of
yes.
weaknesses and yeah.
And some of his moves are so good. His side
yeah, the grenade is also
golden feather.
Really good. Yeah,
and also the down throw into up tilt.
Yeah, the down throw into up tilt. It come as I mean up tilt is a good move, but it doesn't have that much range. Mm. So
and actually, yes, Pachogi won 3-2 against Expansion.
So
it so was really the very
yeah.
last game,
and that's why we saw the pop-up.
So close. Yeah. And Expansion was actually in the lead, so
yeah, he was in
Pachogi
a huge,
had
huge lead
over had 100%, and Expansion had only 30% and then 50%, and then we just said just one more Shoryuken or something like
yeah,
this.
Yeah, the Shoryuken, and it kills so early, especially with rage.
Yes.
Joker. Yeah, so the Joker against Ken, and he doesn't have his tag. But he will probably switch the tag.
I hope he will switch. I hope he will realize. Now he's playing with the Velugi
yeah,
tag.
Yeah, now we saw him.
I hope he.
Yeah, yeah. Wick,
yes.
Wick just told him that he doesn't have the tag.
Okay.
The correct
so
tag,
we
yeah.
saw it first, and then Wick saw it, and now finally also Pachogi realizes.
Yeah.
So we start from the beginning again. Vic versus Pachogi, and the other one, Alex versus Buzzy, is still in the play, so maybe we can see how this one is looking. It's too far away, but
so is this like the last game to get into top 8, right?
Yes.
So the winner will be top 8.
Yes.
Oh. Nice.
And the winner will play against the winner of Alex and Buzzy.
Buzzy, yeah. And did they already play or
they are playing right now?
I mean, I see Buzzy right there, but they will probably...
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah, they will probably play in the near future.
Okay. Or maybe the results.
So Pokemon Stadium, yeah, maybe Gentleman's Agreement, I don't
with
know.
With the Team Galactica music. Yeah. And good start from Bujogi, and I'm sure Bujogi is pumped with
adrenaline. Yeah.
With adrenaline, because when you get this crucial win, you this can relieve some positive energy. And
so interesting, the F tilt from...
Oh no, he missed
unfortunate. That it's stage spike, the down air. But
wow, nice combo! What the hell was this? Goes for the Shoryuken, misses it, but doesn't get punished. Luckily, and this time he gets it, and now it's.
Nice. I mean, he
it's 2-2 again.
Just did the attack on shield, and then Wick thought he is safe to release the shield and punish. Yeah. But with the instant up B, so the instant Shoryuken, he got the kill.
Yes.
And now it's looking even.
And now Bujoge is actually the last can remaining in the... Wow, what a nice spike!
Yeah, what,
holy.
What a down air.
Yes.
Yeah.
Didn't I wanted see that to coming. Say Bujoge is the last can in the tournament because Raban just won 3-0 against Dimiki. Yeah. But Raban is still not in... No, no, yes, he's in
top 8
against True 4, yeah. This will be interesting.
Oh, wow. Really nice
and
combo from...
This looks so good for Bujogi. Just look at this. And
yeah,
he
again, he wanted
again.
To get down air as the last stock in similar fashion, but didn't get it this time. Because Swick was aware of that and he DI'd out.
Yes.
And that's
he's
a whole
gonna
stock
be a
lead. Gary, but yeah.
Ken
nice. Recovers.
I thought it was
the animation.
Yes, it was the kill.
He
yeah,
he
didn't
he
need
didn't,
the
he didn't
down
have
yeah.
He didn't have the meter, the scene meter, right?
Yes,
so
it just ran
it
out.
Just ran out and yeah, couldn't make it back.
What
convincing
great.
Yeah
yes.
First game
because
from,
first Wick was in the lead, but then he got this sick kill. And
I mean,
3-1. And as I said,
I
the
mean,
positive energy
could
from
you
the
imagine
last game.
Wick not getting top 8? I mean, wow.
Yeah,
that just shows how stacked this tournament
yeah,
is.
Wick, the VCA ambassador from the Beefy Smash Dudes. And now it has final destination character with his music and
so
with the wolf.
Yeah, he picked wolf this game. And let's see how. Actually, the start is looking
start is
really
good
from
again, yeah.
Wick. Yeah.
It did last time as well, but
The momentum shifted so quickly after he got the down air off stage,
and Wolf doesn't have the best recovery. So let's see.
Yeah. Nice parry. Oh yeah.
Yeah, he goes for the spikes. Shoryuken,
but not in kill percent.
Yeah. And this will be a huge punish.
It kills, yeah.
Enough for the kill.
Smash.
Yeah, and
yeah,
it's really
nice
that we get another match to
nice
see on stream before.
Yeah.
Wow, almost connected. This time
Shoryuken.
It kills, yes,
for sure. I mean,
but Wick
Shoryuken
is still
is so
really
good. Wow. I'm a bit surprised that he didn't go for the forward tilt or down smash to
scary
like maybe
scary
hit a 2-frame. Oh yeah, so he's on the ledge. How
yeah, it's difficult for Bujogi to get damage done, and
yeah,
he's spacing really well.
I mean, now he kind of has
now he gets a grab.
And advantage situation, but still, I mean, it looked much better. He looked much better
but
in the matchup against Joker.
I mean, he's bringing it back. Look at this. In a match with Joker, he was also behind. And there could be the second kill, and there it is.
Wow, man.
With full rage, Joker, you don't
I
want
mean,
to mess with.
He has such a huge percentage deficit, but it doesn't mean anything because
Wolf doesn't have a kill throw.
Yeah, and
expect at least still, from the front. Now let's see how this turns out.
A nice string of damage.
Yeah.
Wow.
He intercepts his nice with the down B.
Wow.
But also Vic is playing really careful, just not to get too close to Ken, because you don't want to be that close to Ken.
Wow. Nice.
And now you know, 65% this is kill percent if Ken gets one combo.
Yeah, if he gets a combo into Shoryuken. One weak tilt
into Shoryuken could mean
it's
again.
It's really close again.
On the other
side, if Vic gets a big air or something like that, then...
Yeah, and Pochogi now has stage advantage, so maybe he can use it.
Oh no, that's not the Shoryuken he wanted to get.
That was too risky, that was too risky.
I mean, that was obviously a missing foot. I don't see him like reading anything.
I don't know, maybe he read that Vic would jump into the air, I don't know.
Yeah.
We can ask him later. But now it's 1-1 and you can see both
two
players,
more games
at least today, they look equally good.
Yeah.
And Vic again with the come to VCA, we said it already, MK Leo is coming to Austria on 23rd and 24th November. There are only 600 places and you have to register now because it's so unique to have the best player in the world here.
Yeah.
Maybe play against you. Get the chance to play friendlies and...
Oh, nice down air, but...
Yeah, so the shield gets really low from...
but it was not low enough to break, so... Vic aware of that and...
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he wanted to get the fair into
but
down air.
Even though he didn't get it,
he got a lot of percent.
100% is still good. This...
Wow.
Ooh, nice. And he gets it with the Shoryuken. Off stage.
I mean, but still, Wick is in kill percent.
Holy
shit. Pochogi.
Both are in kill percent, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can see Pochogi fishing for these
combos, but
this could
be the back at the ledge.
Yeah, we said no kill throws, but at least from the front, but back throw still kills, so.
Yeah. Oh, he dropped the ledge trip there.
Mm-hmm. And Vic is applying good pressure, and if this down smash had connected, this would have been the second stock, so this was important for Pochogi to avoid. So. But Pochogi struggles to find this opening, and...
Oh, and this Shoryuken,
advantage.
I mean, Shoryuken, even out of shield, it's... So
yeah, he did it well with the down B just before.
Yeah, that could lead in a
lot of and now it looks like he gets those combos that he was missing during the first stock. But now they're back again,
and
Vic just kills
Vic
all the momentum.
Right now,
and now it looks really good for Vic because you can see he still applies pressure. And both are playing more aggressive now. So Vic, Pochogi has to risk something because he can't play only defensive because he is two stocks.
Yeah, he needs to get the kill.
He needs to...
No.
Nice read! Nice
was roll a really
read
nice
into...
Yeah. Tech chasing. I thought he wanted to go for the jab lock, but then he waited it out and got...
Such a clever decision.
Yeah, got it actually.
So just what he needed. Oh, nice roll read from Vic.
Still the F-tilt.
And
F-tilt
Pochogi
on the ledge would...
Pochogi struggles to get back to the stage. And he just barely avoided the smash attack.
Yeah, down throw. But doesn't do much.
except giving him a better. But now position. He's back in the game. Now he's back in the game.
Whoa!
The
unfortunate.
Oh no!
Yeah, dodge man.
Wick knows himself. This was a mistake by his
part.
And
for Pujogi, really lucky that he got this game.
Yes, but
I mean he could have made it back,
yeah.
But
I still think
fortunate
Pujogi
for him, yeah.
Did the pressure, and if Wick didn't
feel the pressure, then he wouldn't.
Yeah, he wouldn't
dodge,
have
yeah.
made a mistake. So it was a forced error. It was.
Yeah,
it was really good by Pujogi, but still, you saw it in the camera. Vic just shake his head and he knew he messed up on this part at least.
Yeah. And we're going back to Stadium 2.
And look at this, Pujogi is actually 2-1 in the lead against Wick. That's
yeah,
crazy.
Who would have thought, man? And it was not just a tease, the snake, he actually goes for it.
Yeah.
But as we know, Pujogi also has a snake. So
he
knows the character really well. But
that's the third character that Wick is playing in this
set,
right?
Yeah.
He started with Joker, then he went to Wolf, and now
I mean he has also an Inkling, so maybe for the last game.
I mean
yeah.
if he wins now with Snake, he will probably stick with Snake.
Yeah. Probably.
But Pujogi also has a lot of experience against Snake because there are so many good Snake players in Vienna and
yeah.
in Austria.
Oh, but it's really nice to see Wick's Snake again.
Yes, but
because it has been such a long time that he last played.
Surely
almost
the punish for it. This
would be hype. Yeah,
yes. Almost a meteor.
But he got him with the C4. Mm-hmm. And yeah, up tilt will kill from Wick.
Yes.
Yeah,
yeah,
he tries to go for it, but
with this lanky hitbox. Yeah.
Oh,
it's
against
him
with Nikita.
Mr. Nikita
upstage. Nikita is such a good option because it involves almost no risk.
But Jogi gets
nice
short himself.
Yeah.
And yeah, every single game between these two is so close.
Yeah, it's so nice to watch.
Yes.
Ooh, the dash attack.
Wow, the smash attack almost!
Oh,
but
I thought Pujogi was just running into it,
but I think he calculated it just perfectly.
Dash attack from...
Yeah. And actually we have the result of the other game, so Buzzy against Alex was also really close. Game 5, 3-2 for Buzzy, so...
Oh, okay.
Yes, the winner will play against Buzzy in top 8. And we just saw the up tilt from Vic.
Yeah, killing
and
now
Wick is
quite
an
elite
lead.
Yeah. And that's maybe the character that he was searching for in this matchup. Because again, as we said before, Ken doesn't like those campy matchups,
mm-hmm.
those projectile heavy opponents, and Snake definitely is one of those.
Yeah, you can't get much more campy than him. Maybe Dakar or a Villager. This could...
Yeah.
Doesn't get a follow-up at this percent.
Oh, wow.
This
that
was the read.
Look. Yeah,
now he...
That was the read.
But Vic has to win this with this much percentage lead.
Yeah, I mean... If Pujogi would bring it back, it would be a huge comeback for him. And Nikita might do it now. He waits it really nice.
190%.
And we know at this percent, yeah, he wanted to go for the grab because it would be a character kill. At the F
nice.
At the.
And now we have another game 5. That's really exciting. This was a deserved victory finally for Wick, and
he will.
It paid off that he switched to Snake. I didn't. Yes.
Yeah, that one was
switching
really nice
characters twice is... You don't see it that often in such an important game, but...
Yeah, I mean it's top 8 qualifiers last round.
But Pujogi now has the advantage to pick Final Destination again, the stage where he won. And the stage where he feels most confident in.
And the Wii Fit Trainer!
And Pujogi goes for the Wii Fit Trainer, it's incredible!
Nah, he stays with Ken.
Okay. Good start from both of them, but now Vic is trapped!
Whoa.
But of course still not enough to get an early kill.
Yeah, the traps with up smash are so good.
Yeah. Yeah, grab. Big punishes the unsafe attack from Vic with the grab.
We always see these B reverses coming out there. I mean, it's so difficult for the opponent to know where he will, his snake is going to land when he does those.
Yeah.
And Nikita.
A lot of pressure from Vic, and Buchogi has to get back to the center of the stage. But he really struggles, and
yeah,
these missiles are too much for him, at least at this point.
Especially with Ken, it's
but
now
it's
hard
fresh
to avoid,
descent, maybe. Maybe he can. Yes, again the chase,
yeah,
and again
the
road
sure
chase.
You
We saw it for the second time in this set, and it's really good from him. And now he brought everything back.
Yeah, and it's I mean it's such a hype set. No, I mean every game 5 set is nice to watch.
And you don't want to be in a last stock situation with Ken, because you know you can die at any time.
Against Ken.
But
with Ken also. But
because you know you can always die.
Wow,
this was
wrong
misinput, yeah.
Yeah.
And so again, this hype Final Destination music, it's really Final Destination Curry.
Yeah. Down throw.
Oh, but he doesn't get the... Chase. He thought he was rolling in, but he still gets the kill with the FT.
At the edge,
so Buchogi is again behind, but maybe he can get the early kill. He goes for the down.
It was the last second air dodge to the stage.
Nice down air, racking up a lot of percent and following up with two dash attacks.
Looking so good for Wick right now.
Nice IB. He searches his opening. Doesn't get it yet. The grab is not the yes. I mean, you take it, but you actually want to get this opening for the Shoryuken.
Yeah, this
is
the Shoryuken.
Yes.
I mean, you saw it.
And now, now we have
drifting in, and now
last stock situation.
Yeah. And as we said before, last stock situation against Ken. It's So
you don't want to be in this situation.
But I mean, he's still at
0%.
But
at this 0% time, Buchogi already has 111%, and that's
just
a lot.
Be aware
that's
of the
a lot.
Here.
There's the first combo, but only 14%. Look at this.
Yeah, it's rough for Buchogi right now. And this is
this
it.
Is yeah
yeah
nice from Vic. He will be very relieved to make top 8, but I think Buchogi can also be proud of himself.
Yeah, he played really well and. It was really close.
It was close again.
I mean,
again
if it wasn't for the swap to Snake, he would probably have won. But yeah, props to Buchogi.
Yeah. So
and this was the last game that we commentated. It was it was a blast with you commentating.
Yes.
Shulkinator.
Thank you.
and we'll see.
Make a small break and then.
Yeah. Then we will later see top 8.
Top 8 with Mercy and who was the second one?
Mercy and
Buchogi. Buchogi, right, Buchogi. The guy who just almost made top 8, so he will have a lot to talk.
Yeah, that's nice.
Okay, thank you.